Hello. Welcome to Card Minds. Thank you for stopping by. This is going to be a Virgo weekly money and career reading from August 5th to the 11th, 2024. Virgos, welcome, welcome. So, my voice is a little different. It's a little lower, a little weaker. But not to worry, just grab your earphones or your headphones to hear the sound better. And I will deliver the messages as usual. All right. Let's get started, Virgo. There will be a magic word at the end of this reading. If you're interested in putting your name in the hat for a free reading, all you have to do is put the magic word down below in the comment section. And be subscribed. I will pull one name and announce it at the end of the month of August. All right, Virgos, second attempt. Let's see what messages we have for this upcoming week. Virgo, weekly money and career, August 5th to the 11th, 2024. Nine of Swords. What's going on, Virgo? Got a little anxiety there, a little stress, leaving something behind. Okay, going on a new adventure. The desire of a new adventure, or this anxiety or this stress regarding a past work situation or something you were waiting for. It feels maybe like you know now that you're moving on to something else. Let's see where this is going. Virgo. Yes, so Two of Cups. Maybe you're partnering up with someone, or let's see if this is the person you're working with. Partnering up with that soul connection. Or is that the person you're leaving behind, or that job, that connection, that person, that partner you're leaving behind? Let's see, Virgo. The cards are coming out one by one, so it's very mysterious. Are you leaving this person behind, or this connection, job, partnership behind? Or is this the person that is boosting you into your new project? Yep, there we go. So this person is contacting you. There's a sudden shift here. Sudden action forward, contacting you, messages, emails, whatever it is. Maybe you're also, maybe not moving, but traveling or working somewhere else, or connecting to someone else and moving to another job or another company, or you're working somewhere else. It feels like this person is contacting you, and that is pushing you into action, leaving the anxiety behind. Yep, it feels like it's something you wanted, you've waited for. Nine of Cups, this is your wish coming true. This is what you wanted. The High Priestess, the Strength, and the Sun. Wow. And here you are, Virgo, with the Sun. Very often you have the Sun moving into abundance, happiness. Now, with this Nine of Cups and this High Priestess, it's you getting the truth, getting those messages, or those answers, or that information, or that callback, or that person, or that company, whatever it is that's giving you information on maybe the next step, or on maybe even this situation here that you're leaving behind. But for me, it's not really it doesn't feel like it's the job you're leaving behind, or a situation you're leaving behind. It is you understanding the emotions or the triggers that were blocking you, the emotional anxiety that was blocking you or not serving you or just, yeah, stopping you from moving forward on something, whether it's your own business or a job or a project, whatever it is. And this person here, and I think we will pull more cards on this Two of Cups to see who this is, what is going on, what is coming in. This person might be opening doors for you, or at least you're getting answers, that messages, that the answers are coming in, or the truth is coming in, or whatever information you're waiting for, or you were frustrated or disillusioned, right? Or whatever was stressing you out because you weren't getting the answer, or you weren't getting what you wanted, you're understanding now that you're opening up to something else, and it's about adapting and sort of managing your new environment. You will manage your new environment. You're stepping into something new, abundant, happy, success, also what you wanted, but you're going to have to, you will be resourceful. You will understand how to adapt with these new people, manage this new team, or manage your energy within this new company, new team, new project, new business, whatever it is, with the Strength card. It's about controlling your environment and understanding what you need to control your environment. And that's really pushing you into this happiness and this balance in being finally maybe in the right space, or feeling comfortable with this job, or because I don't feel like there's no ace. So this is probably something you've been working on, or probably something you've been waiting for, or probably something that's frustrating, or that was frustrating because it wasn't coming in the way you thought it would or what you wanted, right? But this person is really unblocking, finding a solution, or offering you a solution, or offering to work with you to move forward on something with the High Priestess. Maybe more skills, maybe training, or someone offering you the information or the capacity to move forward, to find the resources, or helping you finding the resources to adapt in a new situation. Very, very interesting reading. All right, let's see. I want to pull one more card on this High Priestess. See, what is this message that's coming in? Or what are the truths that are coming in? Or what is it that's coming in that's finally putting you in a comfortable position and bringing you stability in your job, in your business, or in your career path, whatever it is? What is this High Priestess here? What is she giving you? Ooh, yeah, control. Okay, so there can be an Aries, a father figure, or someone you look up to, someone around you, friend, family, a mentor, or a boss, or a coworker, or this person. This person is probably, if this is not you taking control, which you are, you're taking control over a dynamic, right? Finding the answers, finding the solutions, fixing. You are a fixer, Virgo. If this is not you taking control on what is very clear to you on where you stand, what you want, your boundaries, right? Whatever you're leaving behind, this is someone very important in your path, on your path, that is revealing the resources, the sources, the truth, the information to push forward. Yes. I feel like this is a partnership with this Four of Wands, a true partnership, being with the right person that it's almost like you're complementing each other. You both have different resources, different talents, different experience or creativity, whatever it is, and you will complement each other in evolving or building a business or working together on something. And again, you have the Sun. Wow. All right. So what is this you wanted to bring in here with the Nine of Cups? What is this all about? Clarify the Nine of Cups here for me, for Virgo. Clarify the Nine of Cups. Oh, why am I using this? Sorry. Let me just grab the other cards. I don't know why I was using that deck. clarify the Nine of Cups for me? What is it that's coming in? Oh, well, there we go. There we go. New job, new passion, the desire to build. I mean, it feels like this is something passionate. It feels like this is something, yeah, a job you're passionate about, or a subject, or an idea, or a product, whatever it is. This is something that you've worked hard for and that has been your passion for a while, and you are now moving into something new found with this person, or regenerating a new way of doing it, or going back to sources, new sources to build a project, business, whatever it is. And here we have the King of Pentacles. Here you are. So you're stable financially. You're finding the financial resources to gain stability, gain power within this job, business, career, move, whatever it is. Beautiful, beautiful energies here, Virgo. Let's see if there's one last message for the road, Virgo. Weekly, money and career. One last message for the road, Virgo. Yeah, not surprising, the Five of Cups, since we have the Eight of Cups and the Nine of Swords, the anxiety, the disappointment. So whether this is a disappointment in the way it was done before, or what you had in your job, the way it was managed, or why this didn't happen the way you wanted, or the answers you were waiting for, or the truth, whatever, right? That this is the result of the disappointment in that person that didn't, I don't feel like it's a person though, but it might be a person, a company, a group of people, the answer you're waiting for on the interviews, or, right, the possibilities, the opportunities that were just not up to par, and very disappointed in the information or the answers you're getting back. But here comes the winner here with the Two of Cups. This person is sort of propelling you with the eight of wands. So either maybe you're traveling, you can be moving, whatever it is, it's a switch. You're flipping the switch here, Virgo, from something that's disenchanting or disappointing into finding solutions with this person or this company or this entity, whatever it is, that's giving you a new dynamic and a new ambition. Now, you will have to control and manage the environment. You will have to settle in and, you know, find your way. But two times the Sun, I mean, and the Four of Wands, and the Ace of Wands, I mean, all of this with the wish coming true is really you gaining control over your career, your job, whatever it is. Yeah, Five of Swords, done with the past, done with whatever didn't work for you. All right, one last message for the road. Let's move into the future now. Let's see. Let's move into the future. One last message for the road with these two suns and the Ace of Wands. Yes, they're well. We're confirming that. Confirming the finances, the stability, the empowerment you have with this person. Or if it's not a person, it might be a company offering you this job, right? Or offering you the possibility to work for them on a project, or, you know, that idea you have to develop. Beautiful, beautiful reading, Virgo. I want to say that the magic word here is the power of management control. Okay. Management control. That's what's coming. So if you're interested in putting your name in the hat for a free reading, all you have to do is put the words management control in. I have passion coming into. All right. Whatever you wish to put, you can put passion down below in the comment section, or management control, either or all three, if you wish to put your name in the hat for a free reading, Virgos. And don't forget to subscribe or check if you are subscribed. Thank you so, so much for watching. Gratitude to each and everyone connecting to these readings, to this channel. Gratitude from the bottom of my heart to everyone, Virgo. Have a great week. Take care. Bye-bye.